Hello, hello everyone!
Howdy.
And welcome back to Khemia. We are here with a good boy. A really, really good boy. And also Nefidu is here.
Wow. There's allowed to be more than one good boy at the same time.
I guess he's a fine boy. He's fine.
The Last of Us co-creator Neil Druckmann said in an interview with The New Yorker that he believes the HBO show will be the best, most authentic game adaptation yet. Ultimately adding, hopefully, this will put that video game curse to bed.
Excuse me, Mr. Druckmann? Was that his name?
Yeah.
School Days exists. I rest my case. Also, do people just forget that, like, the entire Fate franchise
is a video game?
Is a video game adaptation?
They do forget that.
Okay.
People watch Fate just for the anime, which blows my mind.
I know. Because it was never good.
It was never good. Like, no. Who the fuck?
I prefer the vampire series, Tsukihime.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that one's... As far as I consumed that sub... No, that was the original franchise. It was Tsukihime first, and then the spinoff was Fate, and Fate just ended up being more popular. Just,
yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But I kind of liked how more low to the ground Tsukihime was. It's similar to, like, Garden of Sinners.
Yeah.
Like, it's that level.
The truly Kino choice.
Yeah, those are the two Kino choices in that franchise. And then you have Fate, which is just this, like...
The schlocky...
Which flavor of saber do you want this week?
Yeah, no, it's not good. I never
liked it. I loved how they had a spinoff where it was the Protagoon and Saber in a more, like, docile, like, home relationship.
Yeah.
Just so that people could have, like, their self-insert. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. No, it was something, that's
and I'm
for
like,
sure.
Who is this for?
It's for them, you know?
And does Saber have a character? Because there's just a new version of Saber every series with, like, new personality. Fate fans are screaming at me.
Good. Let them.
Let them seethe. Like,
cope. Have some cope.
Fate was never good, and it was never funny either.
Take your copium and go to bed.
Right?
God.
Man, they made a PS4 remake of the Tsukihime visual novel.
Mm-hmm.
Still didn't come out in English.
R.I.P.
Right? I'm like, are you kidding
me? You just have to learn Japanese. That's all. Easily. Casually. Josh, you learning, like, to read, write, and speak Japanese would solve so many of your problems when it comes to media.
Yes. But also, people would hate me more. Because the sheer entitlement...
The sheer entitlement. You know what? If they can't hang, it's like they say, can't handle the heat, get out of the kitchen. You know?
Facts, though.
If they can't hang, then that's their fault.
Mm-hmm. My mind is not working, especially the part that concerns memory. And though the sedative is powerful, I still feel anxiety prick at the surface.
There ain't a room next to us. Brutus, what the hell did you give him?
Drugs!
Whoa, just the pap. And I guess one of those chill pills to calm him down a bit.
You guess? What did you give Skip? Use the room speakers, please.
I feel the fur on my neck bristle as the sound of a Tem's smooth, sapient-like voice drifts down gently from the ceiling. Skipioi.
It went from an accident to on purpose, and I love that.
Skippy-oy.
Well, because remember, the AIs don't know how to say the names correctly.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Do you wish to reveal your medical history to Nefidu and Brunus? I stare at Nefidu's chest in front of me for a moment, trying to keep my expression normal. Yes? Very well. Skipioi was administered one anti-nausea wafer, 25 milligrams, and one anti-anxiety wafer, 10 milligrams, both within the last hour. He also inhaled approximately 1.75 milligrams of the psychoactive compound ANLA via vaporized papaway. I get lost in Ahm's rather beautiful voice, but he must be saying things that Nephidu doesn't like, because he keeps giving Brunus a very cross looks.
Are there any interactions among these medications?
The antiemetic and anti-anxiety drugs are a potent... Potentiate?
Mm-hmm.
A sedation when used in combination.
And anything that causes one to hear voices?
There's a long pause for some reason. It is only now that I'm understanding how terrible this actually is. They think I'm losing my mental ability, which is exactly what I feared. A psychosis is a rare side effect of papaway consumption, of which auditory hallucinations can result.
I see.
Nephidu glares at Brunus again. Do note that this side effect normally occurs at high doses. According to the medical literature, no psychotic.
There you go.
Symptoms have ever been observed in doses below 10 milligrams.
See, he barely took a puff. I've never seen anyone lose it like that, even when they take too much.
I frown, not necessarily liking the way I'm being talked to, talked about, especially with me sitting right here.
But what about in combination with other drugs? He seems barely able to stay awake. He's so sedated.
Giraffe.
Oh my god. Anyway.
Most people wouldn't even feel a thing from just one.
Yes, but he's a wolf. He's never experienced mind-altering drugs, and I doubt there is much in the medical literature about wolf intolerance to papaway.
If that's all it takes to get him high, then why hasn't he ever freaked out after just sitting next to me?
I mean, has he really sat near you? If you did not know, Pop smells terrible. He likely moved away the moment you got close.
They go back and forth, and I close my eyes, beginning to imagine their voices in a sparring match. Mm-hmm. Sparring match.
Mm-hmm. It's like fighting, but not really.
Yeah, I would throw chows at one another.
And have sparring them spar.
You punch, use your bare fist
to punch this other baby.
This chow in the face.
It's baby fights.
It's baby fights.
Having chows... Putting chows against one another is just baby fights.
I love throwing them into the water.
Oh my god. Sink or swim, baby.
Sink or swim, let's go.
Oh my god. Did you ever raise like a godly chow or a devil chow?
I usually let them stay blue.
Mm.
But I would sometimes have a devil chow because I thought those were cute.
They are cute.
The heaven chow suck. I don't like the coloring. I don't,
you don't like
them?
No,
they look shitty.
You don't
shitty.
Like the white with the
They're
little halo?
They're so shitty.
They're not that bad.
They're so shit.
Don't get me wrong. The devil chows are cuter.
They're definitely cuter.
Mm-hmm.
I loved Eggman just going, Yosh!
Yosh.
Yosh. Yosh. Okay, so like I heard that, and everything will be okay. Everything will be okay. Everything will be okay.
Oh my god. Bless.
Since I only ever used like Tails and Eggman.
Yeah. Man. We've never gotten another like Chow Garden.
No.
We never have. It's so disappointing. I remember I had a friend in elementary school who was playing Sonic Adventure on the Dreamcast,
mm-hmm.
and had a VMU.
Oh.
Like whole ass raising their Chow at school.
Bless.
I was so jealous. It was awesome. And then I went over to their house and just like popped it in the controller of the Dreamcast and there it was on the screen. Oh, it was the coolest thing ever, dude.
The Dreamcast was the height of Sega.
It's true.
It reminds me of the one time Nephidu managed to convince the Wolverine to spar. Despite his build and size, Brunus isn't much of a fighter. The match barely lasted more than a minute before Brunus was on his knees and retching so loud he sounded like a giant squawking bird. I laugh loudly. The voices go quiet again. They're still just being the confused. There we go. I open my eyes and look at them. At this moment, I decide that I'm tired of being gawked at. Is it awked at? Is the G silent?
No, the G's there.
Okay. Mm-hmm. The G's never silent, right? It's gnat?
No, it's not never silent.
It's gnat. It's
silent sometimes.
It's gnawing.
It's not that either.
If the G wasn't there. I mean, if the G is there, it must want to be seen. It wants to be heard.
It's just to fill the word out. Because, like, think about Nat. It would just be N-A-T. And that's not a real
word. What's wrong with that?
Everything. It's not a big enough word for an animal.
That's not an explanation.
It's one syllable, but two. If it's one syllable.
The G wants to be seen.
No, if it's one syllable, but three letters, it's too small to be an animal. Because you have emu, which is three letters, but it's two syllables.
Yeah.
Therefore, a more filled out word.
Wait, how do you spell emu?
E-M-U.
E-M. Wait.
U.
Mu.
Emu.
Yeah, that makes sense. That's all being pronounced.
Emu.
Mu.
Emu.
Yeah, so the U is being pronounced.
Yes.
So all three letters are being pronounced.
Yes, but it's two syllables.
Yeah?
So that, therefore, despite being three letters, it's two syllables means it's a full enough word to be a real word.
What would be wrong with Nat?
It's too short.
That's two syllables.
Nat. One Nat. Word. No. 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 The T at the end of a word does not make another syllable.
Sure it does.
It does not. Not is not is one syllable. Not.
Not.
Shut the fuck up. That is wrong and incorrect, Josh.
It makes sense.
No, it doesn't. A T doesn't make another syllable.
What? Are you saying T's aren't good enough to be their own syllable?
I'm saying it's not how it works. My personal feelings about T don't matter in this discussion.
Yes, it does. Why are you so... Are you racist against T's?
Fuck them.
Would you?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I mean, I guess you can hold those handlebars, right?
Exactly. Like... You got handlebars, bro. Mm-hmm. You got handlebars for sticking it into things and sticking things into it. It's all perfect.
Right.
All the way around.
So I clear my throat again. Did you know that it's rather rude to talk about someone who is in the same room in a way that suggests they are not there? They continue to look surprised until Nefidu seems to break out of trance.
Yes, sorry about that, Skip. You know that Brunus and I often get into it.
Well, discuss something that does not have to do with me, then. I am very tired, so I am going to lie down now.
Ah, I see. Are you sure?
I am fine. It's best not to worry about me. I expect Nefidu to become angry again, and he doesn't. I feel a semblance of guilt under the drug haze, but I earnestly do just want to lie down. So that's what I do, the vague guilt morphing into some smug satisfaction at seeing the two of them left to awkwardly stand around. It's nice not to be the one that is feeling off-kiltered. I think they have left, but their voices mumble back and forth for a while, and then it goes quiet. And then I fall asleep. Okay, that'll be the end of the part, everyone. We'll see you around. End of scene, out of mind.
We're gonna wake back up and it's gonna be the same background.
This is the boat arc.
This
is the boat arc.
All of Khemia. See, I mean, sure.
Do we get to I don't know if we even get to Khemia.
In the
two builds.
We'll see, I guess.
I want it to be that we don't get to Khemia. I want this to be a Dastra's boat arc.
Oh.
Like, we went on hiatus while we're still on the boat.
Oh my god.
And, you know, it's berserk all over again. It's beautiful. It's amazing. You know.
Mm-hmm.
I have extremely vivid dreams. First, of my childhood, I began attending the elite school when I was 13. I was very sad to leave my mother and my friends in the coastal town that I was born in. Still, I was told it was necessary, that my mind was gifted and was destined for greatness.
His mind is so great.
Yep. In the end, I found out that while it was true for most of my classmates, it was clear that I had been admitted for other reasons. Excuse me. My first day, the instructor called me. Called me to solve a problem using math that I had never even heard of in my homeschooling. He framed the problem within a scenario that involved rich families and their young living on estates. The solution to the scenario was the amount of money required to bribe a local official who would then secure a spot in an elite school for one of these rich pups, thus making his point. I was there because my family had connections, and more importantly, because they had money. Money that was being wasted on a stupid, average-brained pup that could only answer questions with, I don't know, while trembling in fear. Then, during mealtime, my mane was pulled and I experienced my first physical fights, one that ended with me curled up on the floor, covering my face. The experience was humiliating, traumatizing even. But as I sobbed quietly in my dorm room alone, wondering how I could possibly survive another day, I became angry. I knew very little about my father at the time, but I did know that he was a figure to be proud of, a professor of arithmetic.
You're almost there, but the pronunciation's different. Remember, we went over this.
I know, but
rhetoric.
So I did have it right.
You did have it right, but you were saying
rhetoric.
Rhetoric.
How is it not rhetoric? Is that a different word?
They're similar words, but different words. Because if you think about like we talked about this during the Adastra playthrough.
I know, but this says rhetoric.
Yeah, it's rhetoric. You're right.
Rhetoric.
In this context, it's rhetoric. In other contexts, that word
would be
rhetoric.
Rhetoric. It's just. Does rhetoric not have an H?
It's the same word. It's spelled the same.
Oh my god.
Come on, Josh. Gotta keep up.
This is as bad as the word read.
Which word read?
Read and read.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's stupid.
That's pretty awful.
I hate that.
It's pretty dumb.
It should be red without the A.
But then it would be the color.
Yeah?
Then that would just give that word two meanings. Which you would still have to use context for.
Yeah.
So how is that any better?
Okay, so here's what we do. We just change the word red to aka.
That way you have one that means color and one that means something else.
Yeah.
I see. Mm-hmm. Sounds like you want to learn Japanese, Josh.
Well, I hear Aka a lot. Aka ninja!
Aka ninja! Aka ranger! Blush.
Though sometimes they just say red.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes they'll use the English word, sometimes they'll use the Japanese. It's very inconsistent. You know, you have Gokai Redo. I knew very little about, rhetoric. The proudest of woven disciplines, one that no sibling could match, not even the Khemians. So I knew I had every reason to be proud of my family name, and I had every right to be in the school. At the beginning, my instructor devoted 5 minutes at the end of each class period to humiliate me with questions he assumed I would not know the answer to. He likely hoped I would quit, but instead I studied, and used what I learned to fight back. Within a month, I was answering more than half his questions correctly, and that's when he stopped. I mentioned his name to my mother in one of my letters, and within weeks he was gone, fired by the headmaster, who my mother knew very well.
Get dunked.
Wow. As soon as my mane was touched, I would swing as hard as I possibly could, fracturing two jaws before the attack stopped altogether. Eventually, I was at the top of my class, and by the time I graduated 5 years later, I was accepted into the most prestigious university on the moon. This is an odd dream. It's more of a narration of my past life.
It's for us, the
audience. It's for, yeah, he's talking to the he might as well have been, "Hi, my name is Skip Yoy, and you must be wondering how I got here. Well, let me tell you."
"Hi, my name's Skip Yoy, and you're watching Disney Channel."
Terrible. It's fucking... Do they still have those?
No, they do not. They don't have bumpers anymore?
That's a little sad.
So, Megan and I were just at a cabin.
Yeah.
And we watched a lot. There was no Wi-Fi. There was hardly any service.
Yeah.
But they had DirecTV, so we watched a lot of Nickelodeon.
Oh, shit.
And literally, it was SpongeBob all day. Then about 2 hours of Loud House before it switched back to SpongeBob for the next, 6 hours. And then it was half an hour of programming of some other show.
Yeah.
Something. And then back to SpongeBob all the way through the night.
People complain about Teen Titans Go.
SpongeBob,
it's so much worse.
Way worse on Nickelodeon.
Yeah.
Way worse. Hold on.
I almost want to check, how Disney's, their air times are.
Yeah.
What do they even show? And
I don't know, because I looked at the guide, but I just, we basically just left it on Nickelodeon.
Yeah.
But their bumper, I mean, it was the same commercials, the same two or three commercials about SpongeBob. And then it would do a little animated bumper of Nick. It would say it was of the word Nick.
Yeah, Nickelodeon.
Or yeah, it just Nick Tunes and just radical skeleton, whatever, blah blah blah. And then it would cut to the show. And those are bumpers now. At least for Nickelodeon.
Okay.
But that, you know, I got everything I needed to know out of the current air status of Nickelodeon as a channel.
Okay, and it's bad. Okay.
Terrible.
Good. Still the worst of the three, cartoon networks. That's weird phrasing. But you know what I mean. Kids' networks. How about that? That works better. But it's important because I fought hard to be here. And I'm beginning to realize that, while I believed those troublesome days of my youth to be over, that might not actually be the case. I need to fight now, for my family's sake, and for my own. I see myself curled up, sobbing after smoking Bernice's pipe, and I sneer in a way that feels very unfamiliar. But it feels good. As those images of my childhood fade, I remember that the school I attended on the outskirts of Lux no longer exists. Oh god, it's Kingdom Hearts. Almost a decade after my graduation, on the same day my life changed at the university. The school was burned to the ground by a mob of men from Lux. Oh god, they're collecting Lux.
They're collecting Lux.
I never researched the aftermath, because while I know most of the pups got out, some of them did not. Because of men who saw those gifted minds as threats. And just like men who tried to kill me. And while I have tried to understand the plights of those who are poor or less educated, I sometimes find myself doing the opposite. Those men were beasts. Violent, stupid beasts who could not reconcile with the fact that they were, in many ways, inherently inferior.
So our boy Scipio here is into eugenics, then.
That's fine.
No, it's not.
Nah, let's just genocide. What does eugenics mean?
You know what? If you don't know, let's just move on.
Wait, Josh, do I have to look up what eugenics is?
No, Josh, you don't need to know what eugenics is.
What's the commenters? Tell me why you think eugenics is good.
Oh my god. It's fine.
Is it fine?
Eugenics is not fine, no, but we are moving on past that.
And that made me, my peers, and my professors a threat to them. This is an incorrect way to think, I know. Yet if I were to strip away all of the etiquette, all of the structured thinking that comes with being an academic, I would want to do the same to places like the Clay District, where most of the men come from. I would like to raz. Raise?
Raise as in to tear down, destroy, flatten. He's saying raise it to the ground.
Yeah, isn't that up?
No. You raise... There's two
raise up.
There's raise up and there's raise down. But they're spelled differently. But they're spelled differently. See? You have no argument. They're spelled differently, Josh.
My argument is that they sound the same and are different words that mean the opposite. And that...
No, Josh, it's fine.
I don't like this. I don't like this. Disgusting place filled with degenerate, disgusting people to the point that it would seem as if it never existed. Like removing a stain from a fabric of a dastardly society. I want to tear them apart. Because my friends, my professors, and a part of my mind have been torn apart. And because the pups burned in the outskirts of Lux have been torn apart. Dissolved into the horror of the amalgamation. They were themselves torn apart before they even knew who they were meant to be. What is this? This disturbingly lucid dream. Is this all a dream? Is this a dream at all? Oh, hey!
Like, is any of this for real?
Yeah.
Or not?
I stare out into... into vast stretches of space in awe of the size and of the simple fact that that universe exists. Vaguely, I wonder if I had died, as if the moment I smoked the pipe, I actually did die. Or maybe our ship somehow crashed and I've been left to float through space forever. Or for only a few more seconds before I suffocate. That would be all right. I decide, even as I take a breath, easy breath of air. I would rather feel this way. It's insignificant and meaningless against the monolithic oppression of the universe. It makes me feel oddly peaceful. My goodness, Skippy Oi. If only... Do you not like Skippy Oi?
It's just funny. I don't expect it half the time, and it just comes out naturally.
Skippy Oi. Well, yeah, that's how you, that's the oi, like, isn't...
It's I-O, Josh. It's not O-I. It's I-O.
Look, I-O is still banned in Yu-Gi-Oh! Like, there's nothing to be scared of. I-O can't hurt you. The order is not imperial. Like, okay. if only your friends and colleagues could hear half of what you think. You sound a bit unstable. Always and forever. A deep but feminine voice comes from a seemingly every direction. Oh, is Katra here?
Oh, maybe.
Yeah.
That'd be cool.
I look around, suddenly feeling as if I'm being spied upon, wondering if the directionless voice is from our own head. What? Amicus would not be happy to hear that you wish to raz entire...
No.
Yeah, raz.
Mm-mm.
Raz Al Ghul.
You know. The Raz Al Ghul. The guy who tears things down.
Yeah. Districts to cleanse Adastra of its lower class. The fur on my neck prickles. I still have no idea what is happening. If this is truly a dream, or possibly even another side effect of the drugs. I didn't mean to think those things. I don't truly believe them, I mean. There's a deep, raspy chuckle, one that I recognize as distinctly feminine, the one I'd heard many times from recordings that involved Hindos. And I don't believe that, young wolf. And good guess, especially for one who has never met a tiger.
Yeah, it's Katra.
Yeah.
It's the same portrait.
It's the same portrait. But can you guess who I actually am?
I do like her design, though. I think she's really cute.
Isn't he?
Mm-hmm.
She could be in Senran Kagura. Her eyes are so piercing, so intense, that although I want to ask again what exactly is happening, I feel obligated to answer. Like, can't you just see this coat just shattering off?
I mean, but she doesn't have enough titties.
Not all of the girls have big titties.
They're all pretty breastily boobling.
Yeah, but you have a couple characters that are like...
I don't know, Josh.
There are like 30 girls. There must be a flat-chested one.
I don't think so. I'm pretty sure you're wrong.
Senran Kagura design stream when?
Oh my god. Yo, let's do it though.
You're right.
Your viewers will jump in and immediately jump out. Because they are not here for any of that.
But tits are life. Ass is hometown.
It's true. Get with the program, fellas. Sorry.
Her eyes are so piercing, so intense, that although I want to ask again what exactly is happening, I feel obligated to answer. And so I quickly run through a list of tigresses I know, only one of which is alive, the current ruler of Hindo.
Maharani Arti?
The tigress eyes me closely so that I lower my eyes, just wishing that I could wake up soon. Consider the impossibility of where you are. You think Arti would try to come all the way here to talk to some pup? I swallow hard, trying to keep my breathing even, because whatever this is, I think that it is somehow real. Oh, which makes the possibility that this being can read my mind all the more disturbing.
It's interesting that we're talking to her, but I don't know why.
Well, because we're playing as a protagonist.
True.
There we go.
So I guess that means we have to, huh?
But there could be an explanation. Are you Mira? The quiet smile on her face answers my question. Well, I suppose two attempts is not terrible. Ah, see... She understands the branding.
Attempts.
Yeah.
Trademark. We should sue.
I'm going to formally file a lawsuit against Mira.
Against Mira, specifically.
Though I must say that the human knew immediately. He's dead, honey. Like, you
know? No, he's currently arrested and in quarantine.
No, he died.
Bringing back dog sickness.
Didn't he die in this continuity?
Not in this continuity.
I thought they mentioned that, I thought Nefertiti mentioned that, like, he got slashed in the throat.
Well, that still happened, and he still won. He still lived.
Did that happen in that? I thought him getting slashed in the neck was only for the ending where he died.
No, he still got slashed in the neck, and then Amicus made a deal with the parents to, like...
Oh, that's right.
He
that's
has,
right,
like, yeah. Tech in his throat now.
Yeah, that's right. Okay. Mm-hmm.
So the slashing still happened.
But I want it just... to be... The canon route is that he got slashed in the neck and died.
That would be nice, but it's unfortunately not the canon route. So he's currently in jail quarantine for bringing COVID from the alien planet to Earth.
He brought furry COVID to you.
No, it's just regular COVID. That's how he got here.
No. Amicus is human? If that is how you refer to him, yes. My explanation is seemingly more likely. Yeah, but I can't imagine why this would be the case. Mira stays silent. Though the knowing look on her face tells me that she's waiting. Are the parents doing this? Are they making contact with me? Just like it is rumored that they did with the human. Mira is quiet for a while, so I stay quiet as well, unable to think of any other reason for this to be happening, if this is really happening. The parents are a complex matter, Scipioi. Direct communication with them is impossible, unless they break their own rules involving interference.
Which is fine, because they're the parents, right?
Yeah, they can do what they want.
But whatever.
They can floss out in the void of space, it's all good. I try to think of something else to say, but it is clear Mira is holding back something. Instead, I try to be more direct. Why did you bring me here? Is there something that I am supposed to do? Or maybe you have instructions? Well, Scipioi, I heard you. You are in need of guidance. You are wounded, but in the place that cannot be physically treated. Amira taps a finger on her head.
Oh, we're getting therapy from a ghost.
Yeah. You fear death. You fear the amalgamation. Rather, you feel it is an abomination. And deep down, though you will not admit it even to yourself. My hackles won't stay down, and now I just want to wake up. You do not trust the parents. Am I going to be punished? They knew I'm a fraud, on a mission to further parental agendas, when I don't truly believe in them.
Ooh.
I'm only here for selfish reasons, and that's fine. I realize my legs are trembling. Please wake up. Amira raises a paw. Easy, young wolf. I'm only here to help you, to warn, and to advise. You need guidance. And I am here to offer it to you. Will you take it? I frown and rack my brain for the lessons I had on Mira, if she was ever used in this manner in the past. Her main purpose was that of self-sacrifice, to push Drusus in the correct direction for the Empire. She has little to do with the parents. As far as I know, it is only the monitors that communicate for the parents. Does that mean that this is not sanctioned mm-hmm. by the parents? Yes. And do not be afraid that you are not in lockstep with their vision for the future. I certainly am not. I never entered the amalgamation as I believe that is an attack on life. As I believe that is, yeah, rather than a preservation of it. And in the end, neither are they. They bicker just as much as the siblings.
I like Mira a lot. I think she's cool.
Yeah, yeah. But I think I'll end the part here. Okay. Knowing my luck, there'll be 5 more minutes in the next part.
Fair enough.
So lit. Well, we'll get there, everyone. We'll see you around.